mistake. As I rolled over in my wine-colored satin, I could still smell his scent. Tears rolled down my cheeks as I thought of the good times, and I hated to be at square one all over again. Slowly, I crawled out of the bed and sat on the edge. Between all the drama, I had worked very diligently on creating several web quests in science and various countries for my ESL classes. I walked to the kitchen to get some water to quench my thirst, my brow furrowed with contemplation. My kitchen was caramel with stained wood cabinets and multicolored granite countertops and a ceramic tile floor. It all started last night. Peering out the back window, I enjoyed the serenity of the plush green backyard. Raindrops splashed against the window pane. Yesterday, I had returned home from work. Reggie, I'm here. Are you ready to go? I repeated. I kicked off my black shoes and walked on the white plush carpet of my new house. I had a really tough day. What would you like to eat? Gazing at him through 11 eyes, my heart ached because I still needed and wanted him. Reggie, 50 years old, stroked his brown face and continued to stare off into space. Reggie and I had been together 4 years. 4 years of hell and marital bliss, if you ask me. At times, Reggie was very seductive and charming with his boyish looks. But what's a girl supposed to do? He just sat there on the couch and said nothing. Since my test results, meeting someone new was out of the question. I just didn't have the courage to divorce and to love again. I kept hoping and praying he would change. Reggie, are you ready to go? Still, he said nothing. He had asked me to take him to see his son, Oscar. Oscar was in the fifth grade, a decent kid unlike the others. For the past several months, I begged Reggie to go and see his son. The absent father at times. Glad I didn't have to grow up like that. Grateful. But he always made excuses. Excuses not to work on this marriage. Excuses about his kids. Excuses about money. Sitting at the dining room table, Reggie had prepared a delicious dinner of meatloaf and mashed potatoes. She was a great cook with certain items. I went to my office and sent an email to my mom. As I was checking my email, Reggie blasted, "Girl, I don't know what you tripping off of. Let's go, you wasting time. I'm very upset, you know, how I am about giving my personal information. I just don't like it. My parents lost their insurance because of an accident found on the CLUE report with my name attached to it. They asked my parents for proof of my current address. As far as I was concerned, it is not their business. Tell you what, I would just wait in the car. I got into my old Bonneville and waited. Finally, he got into the car. I could tell by the countenance of his face that we were going to argue. We battled about everything. Sometimes I didn't even know what we fought about. I just wanted peace. Just as I predicted, here it was. How did you get a full tank of gas? I thought you didn't have any money. Give me some. I admit it. I used my card, and it's in the negative now. I need that money to straighten out my bank account. He continued to complain about my friends. Reggie called them the back-to-back girls, Dawaya, Shemaine, and Tremaine. You don't need to tell them about your man, he said. He claimed all the girls had useless advice that got me in trouble, but they were not the ones starting the argument. Was he just determined to destroy everything of value in his life right away? Jag har inte sett det.